Z's, man, everything you need to know. Let's get it popping, man. Just talk about Fat Man Barkley. Charles Barkley, NBA Hall of Famer, TNT analyst, you know, along with Kenny Smith, Shaq, you know what I mean? Shit, they made, Charles Barkley made some comments, player for Boston Celtics, Isaiah Thomas lost his sister a few days ago, Fat Man Barkley made some comments. Isaiah Thomas was on the, he was on the bench, you know, before the game started, and he was crying. Barkley made some comments saying he shouldn't be on the bench crying. It's very uncomfortable watching him cry on the bench. He shouldn't be on the bench crying. If he's crying on the bench, this is a man that's in distress. Obviously, he shouldn't be playing. And there's been a whole backlash, outrage about what Barkley said. Fat Man Wrangler's Barkley. The Wrangler's Barkley, yes. It's been an outrage, which I don't think it should be much outrage. Barkley done said way more critical bullshit than that. You feel me? Against a whole race of people, politically and everything else, man. You feel me? I don't think it should be a big outrage, this shit, man. That's just Fat Man Barkley walking the tight line. But that, you know, that wasn't a bad statement in my opinion. You feel me? If somebody is breaking down like that on the bench before a game, you can, you know, it's obvious to question, are they mentally there to play at a high level in a playoff game? Maybe they should be away recouping with the family, you know, who suffered their loss of a loved one, man. I really don't think it's that bad. Barkley done said way tougher shit. You feel me? But it's fresh wounds. And really, Fat Man Barkley, he don't get the benefit of the doubt of this shit. You feel me? Because he just said such fucked up things in the past. He really don't get the benefit of the doubt. So this coming from him, it's going to be a backlash. It's going to be outrage. You feel me? Some people say it was insensitive. It could have been, but, you know, just watching the man tear up and just break down on the bench like that, just losing his sister, watching this before a game that you play. It is uncomfortable to watch. It is uncomfortable to watch. But was Barkley saying that? I think this is where the backlash come in. People might have thought Barkley, him saying that, people might have thought Barkley was saying that Isaiah Thomas is soft for breaking down on the bench before the game on national television. People might have interpreted that as Barkley saying he was soft. You feel me? But, you know, Fat Man Barkley, he don't get no passes. He done fucked up in the past. You feel me? Wrangler's Fat Man Barkley. You know, but I don't think, just my personal opinion, I don't think that's what Barkley was saying. I think he was just saying, look at him breaking down like that on the bench. He's not mentally there to play a playoff game, man. Step away. Go be with your family, man. That's all he was saying. I want to know what y'all think, man. Was Fat Man Barkley wrong for saying this? Was he wrong? You know, hit my motherfucking comments. Let me know. Was Fat Man Barkley wrong for saying this, man? Like I said, just visibly looking at a man breakdown. Yeah, it might not even been a player hypothetically who had lost someone. If a man was just breaking down for another reason, you know, divorce or anything, you feel me? Shit, maybe he just lost his kids to the court system or, you know, to an ex-wife in a bad breakup, a bad split or something. And she took the kids and motherfucker was breaking down on the bench. Questioning, was he right to make them statements, man? After this man just lost his sister, was he right or wrong to make the statements? Or maybe he should have just shut the fuck up and know that he wasn't gonna get no pass because of the shit he said in the past. Let me know what y'all think. Leave a comment. Charles E's platform. Subscribe, share, like. I appreciate it. Peace.